There are many great tutorials about using signals in Godot, but one feature that doesn't get mentioned is how to use signals without a script. In this example, I have a text, and when I click this button, I want to change the text. Let's look at the setup. I have a label to display the text, then a button, which if we select the Node tab, we are going to connect the press signal. However, we don't have a script to connect the signal to, just as the warning says. Now, in the case you don't have a script to connect to, you can select the node in which you want to change its property. In our case, that's the label node. Then over here, you see a button which allows you to select a method from a script which we do not have. However, if you take a look at the bottom right of this window, you see two check buttons. And once you disable both buttons, a list of built-in methods from the label and its parent appear for us to connect to. Now, we want to change the text of our label. So I'm going to filter the method, and there is a set text method which requires a string argument. So select the set text and click on OK. So we want to pass a string argument to the set text method. You can do that by first enabling the advanced option. Here we can add an argument which will be binded to our set text method. Change the type to a string and click add. Now we can pass our string value. Now you have to make sure the number of arguments you pass isn't more than the method can receive, else this will flag an error. Set the text in the argument, and once you're done, click the connect button to connect the signal. We'll run the program. So our text says hey there, and if we click the button, it now says signals are amazing. Now let's try something a little more complex. When the button is clicked, we'll change the button state and its text. And after a set period of time, the text is changed to its previous text and the button state and text is changed as well. In the scene setup, this time I've added a timer node and we have enabled the one shot property. We are going to select the button, and this time there are four things we need to do. We need to change the label text, which we have already, then set the button state to disabled and change its text as well. Last off is to start our timer, which very soon will change everything back to how they originally were when the timeout signal is emitted. Back to the editor, when the button is pressed, we also want to disable the button. So we will look for the set disabled method. Then as an argument, we want to pass a boolean value, and this will pass true as its argument. Click on connect. Now let's change the button text. So look for the set text method, and this will receive a string of text as its argument. Once you are done, click on connect. And lastly, for our button, let's start the timer. The timer has a start method which receives a float for its wait time. Change its type to float, and I'm going to pass 3.5 as its argument. Hit connect. Now for the timer, when the timeout signal is emitted, you simply just need to change the label text back to the previous text, then set the button disable property to false and the button text to the previous text. I'm going to skip that step since it's the same process. Now once we run the program and we click the button, the text is being changed. So is the body state and its text. And after a set period of time, everything is reversed back to how it originally was. Let's take a look at one more example, which is a little similar to the previous one, and I already have the scene set up. This time we change the label node to an animated sprite, and our animated sprite has two animations, an attack animation, and this has its loop turned off, and an idle animation which has been set to autoplay when the game starts. Let's take a look at the signal. We connected the animation finish signal, and the first thing we did was change the animation back to idle. Then we changed the button text and its state. And for the button, we set the button to be disabled. Then we played the attack animation and changed the button text. And once we run the program, the idle animation is being played. Now we click on attack. This is amazing. However, while this method can be incredibly convenient and easy to use, it's important to understand its limitation. The first obviously being its limited flexibility. Without a script, you are restricted to predefined actions available in the editor, which means you can't easily implement complex logic or custom behavior. Another obvious choice is that this is entirely not readable, and other disadvantages like this can make debugging difficult or maintenance challenges. Overall, while using signals without a script can be quick and convenient for simple tasks, relying on scripting for signal management is a much better approach for more complex and larger projects. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next.